with no further ado, please give a very warm return welcome to the Countess of Wessex String Orchestra under their Director of Music, Major David Cabot.
Thank you. Thank you very much, everyone. I hope you enjoyed our premature telling the joker or the jester. First thing I really have to say, though, is that there's a slight change to the programme. Not the programme we have printed in front of you, but we did advertise that the clarinetist David Wong was going to be performing with us. Unfortunately, he's got tonsillitis, so can't perform. We have adjusted the programme the last couple of days, so I hope you will approve with our substitutions. The first of which is Carmen's Whistle. William Byrd, at the time of the Fitzwilliam virginal book, and an arrangement in some set of variations by Granville Bantock. And these come from a time, beginning of the 20th century, when Renaissance or Tudor music was being rediscovered by British composers. And Bantock was one of the champions, along with people like Peter Warlock. And this is, as I say, a set of variations on the Carmen's Whistle. Apparently, in Tudor time, Carmen literally a man who was having a horse and cart, and they were renowned for their whistling to horses. So that's where the title comes from. Carmen's Whistle.
Thank you.
Bam Tok, some of you may have heard him or know his music very well. An overture, the Piero of the Minute, was probably his most famous overture in the early 20th century. And he has been actually called one of the greatest composers of the early 20th century by many music critics alongside Elgar, and I think you'll see a resurgence of his music. However, like most professional musicians, composers, and conductors at the time, at the turn of the 19th and 20th century, he cut his teeth on seaside resorts. And he was the musical director of the New Brighton Tower Orchestra in the mouth of the River Mersey. And he set about entertaining all those who were going to take the sea air and made himself actually quite famous and popular by mixing light music with sort of more standard classical repertoire, and eventually became director of music at the University of Birmingham. And one of the pieces he wrote was called Hamabdu, which I'm going to perform for you now. Now, Bam Tok was very eccentric. He collected animals as pets, including hundreds of goldfish, and he had another eccentricity, which was to carry around with him fresh plums all the time, which he would offer to unsuspecting people he spoke to. So he's the sort of chap he was. He also had an interest in the East, and this is where Hamabdil, the title, comes from. It's a Hebrew melody, and you don't often hear it in this version. It's usually performed with harp and cello, but he actually wrote it originally for cello, strings, and piano. And this is a version you're going to hear today, with a solo performed by an arts corporal, Adrian Cuff.
Thank you.
and he writes a lot of light music for us. This piece, Horizon Lavender, is one we perform at Buckingham Palace when we play for investors and like. And actually, all the music you've got in your programme today, all the music we're playing, will be performed for royalty at some point in the next few months. It tends to stay on the lighter side, but we do sneak in the odd more difficult piece when people are milling around. So this piece is a lovely waltz, and I think, well, I'm sure you'll like it. If you're not sort of swaying in your seats, it's Iris and Lavender by Peter Wilson.
Thank you.
say that I think it's from the greatest musical ever written. So tonight on the side. Sometimes known as the Jazz Suite number 2. And this is an arrangement of the waltz from the Jazz Suite number 2. And it's got it's got slightly darker undertones than the other waltz we heard, and very much Shostakovich, but still in his light music vein.
Thank you.
terms of Shostakovich, so recognisable as Shostakovich. Now, I do take great delight in uncovering pieces that aren't often performed, and the next piece, I think, is the Goossens piece on the programme by the Tarn. We've had some discussion in the orchestra about what Tarn it is. With Goossens' French and Belgian background, I originally thought it was the River Tarn in the south of France, and the region of the Tarn. However, we're moving towards the fact that it is a tarn in the Lake District, as in a glacial lake, because he did spend some time in the Lake District. So I had it pointed out to me by members of the orchestra, probably more likely, and I'm going with that. However, you can think of it as you wish, but it definitely has either mountain trickles or source trickles from a river or a lake, the tributaries. And it's a wonderful piece that Goossens, again, who became a very famous conductor in America and Britain, and he had two other brothers who played with, who also cut their teeth on the peer orchestras, as Gustav Holst did. And his programme can be, their names, the Goossens brothers, can be seen on programmes at Eastbourne and Bournemouth, along with Granville Bantop as well. So they all sort of knew each other. But this piece is a very impressionistic, either a glacial tarn in the Lake District or a hot river in south of France, and up to you. But it's a lovely little miniature by Eugene Goossens.
Thank you.
piece. I'd just like to say that if you've enjoyed our short concert today and you'd like to come for more and let known about our other activities, there's a sheet at the back of the hall if you'd like to write down your email address, and we can then send you details of our next concerts and activities. There are some on the back of your programme already. Do please give us your email address if you wish to. And our next actual concert is on Tuesday, lunchtime at Guards Chapel, where we have string trio and a flute from the band of Coldstream Guards playing a complete Mozart flute quartets. And then later in the month, on Tuesday the 27th, we've got quite a different concert, very much eclectic taste. We have Lully, Darius Mio, William Lloyd Webber, Glazunov's saxophone concerto. I'm sure there's one other piece in there as well, I can't remember. And the last piece in the second half is the Pierre Lunaire Schoenberg's piece for Sprechstunde and small ensemble. So if you want to come near that, it'll be on the 27th of February, the Guards Chapel in the evening at 7 o'clock. So to our last piece today, we sort of return to interpretations of old music, and this is Frank Farkas's suite, Alla Ungariska. And Farkas, a Hungarian, although he wrote this piece in the early 70s, he actually studied with Respighi in Rome in the 1930s, and it was Respighi who introduced him to early music. Although it took him some years to... he wrote some other pieces with early music in it, but for string orchestra, this piece is wonderful, and it includes mainly Hungarian dances from the 16th century, in six short movements.